have the right to defend ourselves, whether the weapon is a gun or a shoe. However, we must know the difference between an imagined threat and a real one. In other words, you just can't go out and hit someone because you think they're going to hit you. Preemptive action is illegal, unless the attacker clearly demonstrates his intention to inflict harm. In the heat of the moment, tempers are flaring, words exchanged. I can see how a reasonable person might perceive an upraised arm as a threat. I am convinced that Commander Roberts thought his brother was in danger, and he acted in his defense. I therefore find the defendant not guilty of assault.
Court is adjourned.
You did it! You did it!
Commander Turner.
Yes, ma'am.
I lost a son in Iraq, but I still have a daughter there, and she's serving in the 3rd Armored Cavalry Regiment, and I respect her decision to serve. So next time, you think twice about accusing a judge of bias.
Yes, ma'am.
I really want to apologize about Aisha. That's not her. She's just upset.
That's okay. But you really think it's the right thing to make her go to the hospital if she doesn't want to go?
You think she's right?
I don't know. But I'm an inner-city high school principal, and I'm also a father, and I'm a little short on sympathy for people who choose alcohol over their children.
My ex-husband has a disease. Oh, so you don't think alcoholism is a disease?
I think we all make choices in this life. You know, you choose the behavior, you choose the consequences.
There is nothing you can say that's going to make me believe that he chose that.
Yeah, but the question now is, what's really best for Aisha, right?
We can't choose our parents, Mr. Harper. The most we can do is make peace with them. That is what I want for my daughter.
Baby, you're gonna be just fine. We're in the hospital now, but you're gonna be okay.
You're
gonna be okay.
Head and neck on my count.
It's gonna be okay,
right? They're gonna do everything they can, Mrs. Walters.
But what does that mean? I want to be in there with her.
Let the doctors take care of her now. No. All right? I'll stay with you. Come on.
Understand. I don't understand. She was in the park. She was running. She was playing soccer. And then she fell down. I thought she had tripped. And then the sound of the gunshot came.
Uh-huh.
That the sound comes later. How can that be? I don't understand how she's playing soccer 1 minute, and then the next minute she falls down.
Sorry.
I need my baby to live.
Okay, ready? Let's go.
You got to tell me that my baby's going to live. My baby's got to live.
Just take it easy.
Oh, no! No!
Mrs. Watts.
Go again.
No!
It's okay.
Tell me. Tell me.
Let it out. Let it out.
Oh, my God.
What is she doing?
Oh, my God.
I just need to know why. Maybe if you explain that to me, I can make some sense of it. Why, Robert? Why?
But I didn't know it was going to come to this.
And that's your answer? You didn't know it would come to this? You didn't care because you were so selfish and self-consumed. And I was so stupid and blind, I didn't see it. I looked the other way instead of asking questions. I was the perfect wife, wasn't I, Robert? Pretty, smart, and not too curious. Elise was right. We're a family that speaks to each other, but we never really talk.
And if we had talked, what would you have asked me?
I would have asked you where you were all those nights. I would have asked you why everything is paid for in cash. Why strange people are calling us at all hours of the day and the night. I would have asked a lot.
And you really think that the answers would have made a difference?
It was really kind of sad, Robert. We have been married for 20 years. And we hardly know each other.
Mr.
Okay, Jake.
This is Jenna Rutherford reporting live from Shackleton Prison, where what was supposed to have been a poetry contest has turned into something else entirely. As you can see behind me, there's a protest going on. A protest against the closing of the school here. The kids say that all they want is their constitutional right, their right to an education, their right to keep their school open. And they say they don't understand why the state wants to take that away from them.
So what brings you by today?
I stubbed my toe yesterday and I figured since I was here, why not take an HIV test?
Well, no problem. Now, is there any reason to believe you may have contracted HIV?
Oh, no. This is just for my girlfriend, you know. Whatever happened to the good old days of just flowers and candy?
Well, I just wish more women were as responsible. Men are so impatient when it comes to sex. And I try to let
Just give me the test.
Okay, first, let's discuss your risk level.
Hold on. There is none. I feel good, and I look even better.
Lex, 1 in 3 people who have HIV don't even know it. In fact, it's becoming the leading cause of death among African Americans 25 to 44 years old. Take a look at this.
Wow. Whatever happened to good old heart attacks and car accidents?
Yeah, Flex, those were the good times. But unfortunately, HIV is on the rise globally. Look at that. 2 out of every 5 new HIV cases are from heterosexual transmission. So, how many sex partners have you had?
Why, Dr. T, shouldn't we be having this conversation over wine?
Oh.
8 or 9. Give or take a 0. Look, but I have always practiced safe sex. I said practice. I didn't say perfect.
All right, Flex. Well, think about it this way. If you have had sex with just 10 women, and each one of them has had sex with 10 men, who have each had sex with 10 other people, and so on and so on and so on, well, Flex, conceivably, you could have had sex with as many as 100,000 people.